Before I get into the main part of this video, I want to put this at the front so everybody understands how this is linked to what I'm about to cover. After I got the meme that I'm about to show you in just a few minutes on the video, I got this forwarded to me by a different mom. What I actually got forwarded is under here, but I want you to see this part. This is what I sent to the FOIA office asking them for records, because General Wins has announced that he is rewriting the entire strategic plan 2039. 2039 is the 200th anniversary of VMI. And General P already had that written and in motion. He's rewriting it, and they are using a consultancy company to send out a survey and make recommendations. Does this sound familiar? Like Barnes and Thornburg? And this company is linked to Governor Wilder. Governor Wilder was linked to the initial tax on VMI. So if you're not paying attention, just so you know, the initial tax on VMI were not organic. They were set in motion and planned ahead of time, down to the athletes that they picked and coordinated with to make the complaints, to give the stories, to work with a couple key people inside the school to manufacture the outrage, to give Northam the fuel to be able to kick this thing off, to start the Barnes and Thornburg report, to get these everybody in place, to now get to this point so they could rewrite the entire strategic plan of VMI. And now let's get to the video so you can understand the mindset of what we just now learned. There was suspicion, but we just now, I mean, we're so, I'll let you watch the rest of the video and you can decide. Hey everybody, this is gonna be a very serious video, but it's so serious that I'm going to have to punctuate it with humor. So I have some clips of comedians demonstrating why what we're going to talk about is so ridiculously absurd.
Who's more racist, black people or white people? Black people. You know why? Because we hate black people too. Everything white people don't like about black people really don't like about black people. There's some shit going on with black people right now. It's like a civil war going on with black people.
I'll just get right to the content. There's a meme that I'm going to put on the screen. This is General Wins and his BFF, David Estes. And I don't believe I'm doing anything wrong by showing this, because these posts that Mr. Estes made were pulled from Facebook and they were sent to me by a VMI mom, because people are starting to send stuff to me now. And I'm not even on Facebook anymore. That's a long story. I got my laptop crashed, my password. I had an old email account, whatever. So that's why I haven't been on the friends and family pages. But here's General Wins's friend. Apparently they spend a lot of time together. They're BRs, I believe. I'm almost sure of it. I actually don't know if the term BR means that you were in the same class or if it just means any other brother that went to VMI, but this is how racist this guy is. I mean, there is this huge movement of racism against white people, and there's a whole group, a whole subset of black people in America that are bitter and angry, and communists found them and started whispering in their ear, and they convinced them to make the old class warfare race warfare, but still class-based. So the whole message of you're being oppressed, blah, 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 these people bought into it. And here's General Wins's friend, who obviously spends a lot of time with him. And I can tell you, especially at that stage in life, and I'm not that many years behind those guys, maybe
10 or 11 years, you select the friends that you keep, and they're curated, like you would select the best paintings for a museum or for your home. By the time you reach this stage in life, all the acquaintances, all the people that you think are a little wacko, you've purged. I mean, I'm at that stage. I'm doing that in my 40s. I just don't have time for stupidity. Well, this guy is in General Wins's inner circle. So while we don't have this direct quote from General Wins, it's about as close as you're going to get. So here is the proof. Here is the proof. I know it's just a meme, but it does not take a rocket scientist to make this connection.
Say that if we were looking at the demographics at Wisdom School and what those numbers were, you probably could say that it was predominantly white males or something that did not substitute for those in terms of qualified education.
I have been trying to give General Wins the benefit of the doubt, and here's why. First of all, I listened to what he said. I judged his character when he arrived, and not his skin color. Not that there would be a judgment about skin color, because my best friends are black. In high school, my best friend was black. In the military, my best friend was black. I just my friend from the military, Eric, I would still take a bullet for him to this day. We don't get to talk as often as I'd like. Our lives have gone in different directions. We're in different locations, but we still keep in touch. And he was there for me when... Okay, let's try this again. Eric and I were in the Air Force together, and then we worked at two companies after that. And we literally had hundreds of hours to talk. We were on the same team. We rotated through the sections of our comm squadron shop on Langley, did everything together, like checking the generators, piling sandbags, wearing gas masks during exercises, just the whole thing. And we had time to talk. And one of the things that I learned about him early on was that he had gotten a scholarship and then dropped out. I don't know if he dropped out for academics or got cut from the basketball team. I actually don't remember the details of that, but I remember being kind of upset that he had gotten a scholarship, because I had desperately wanted to go to college to get out of my family's poverty.
Father leaves home on Christmas Eve, leaves your family all alone. Had a mother had to sweep out the steps at a prison just to earn enough money for tuition for you. Your brother loses a leg in a tragic bass fishing accident. I mean, there's been a horrific list of things that have happened to you in your life.
I'm not going to cry, Roy.
And I couldn't afford it, which was why I was in the Air Force. And he had gotten a scholarship, and he didn't use it or didn't finish using it. So I was like, why? I was mad. I'm like, why would you get a scholarship when your family makes more money than my family does? And so we had that whole conversation about affirmative action and the assumptions that we had about each other's backgrounds, etc. And then we just grew to love each other. Anyway, we were in a highly technical field, and Eric just blew it out of the water. I learned what I needed to do. And it took me a while, and then I became very good at what I did. But Eric had a natural ability there. He was incredibly intelligent. And that's why all of these, that short story blows apart so many assumptions that ignorant people like this guy makes.
But stop blaming the white man. Okay, I got a white friend. Shit. I don't drink with the motherfuckers because they get fucked up, like Cat Williams say. But I got a white friend. They helped me out, I helped them out. Shit. Hell, my sister even got white friends.
and shit. They all got each other's back, okay? But I know damn well I can't count on one hand how many Negroes got my back. But let me tell you, I can count on your hand, my hand, on how many white folks done helped me out. So I'm just trying to figure out why y'all mad. Share this shit. Talk your shit. But ain't none got no damn slaves. Don't blame the white man, okay? The shit going on in your life, okay? Didn't nobody tell you smoke them damn drugs and go to jail? Didn't nobody, the white man did not put your head down on the table and make you start that crap. You did that your damn self.
And anybody that hasn't been brainwashed by some doctrine rhetoric, you know, this, the mom that sent me, actually it wasn't her, somebody else sent me this guy's, the extended post that he has, and he's talking about stuff that happened in the 1800s. It's 2022. If for no other reason, because I'm seeing this connection, actually Branham Tatum has a clip on this about how every time people talk about this foolishness, this CRT stuff, the advocates that are like, all white people are evil, which is exactly what this guy said. They always reference things that happened 100 years ago.
Black women have never had the ability to have autonomy over our bodies, and that is a lie. This is not, we're not in color purple days where Mr. would just climb on top of us and do his business. This is 2022, and women have the ability to decide yes or no, I want to have sex or I don't. That is not the truth, and I want us to stop lying about it, and I want us to be honest, and I want us as women to be responsible and have accountability and stop trying to blame everybody else for what's going on with our bodies. We have and the right to choose, and that's just what it is.
Thank you. See, that's the difference between successful, in my opinion, successful black women and dead black women. These women, like the young lady right here, if she have children, I would argue that she would, if I had to roll the dice, I would argue that she would be raising young men to be strong and powerful and believe in themselves and do the right thing. The other woman will raise victims, telling them that it's funny. Can y'all understand it? Every time black liberals argue, they go all the way back to slavery. They go all the way back. They skip over all the stuff that black people have accomplished to go right to slavery. And then they skip back over here and try to apply it today. You know how much happened between slavery and today? Do you know how much happened?
Not acknowledging anything that's happened in the United States. All the blood that was shed, all of the fighting, all of the changes that have happened so that we could be at a place where we are now. And here's the funny thing. This is what I figured out. Here's my complex strategic analysis. General Wins and his buddy they graduated VMI in 1985, which means they were raised in that generation, still coming out right after the Civil Rights Movement. So they would have been kids sometime in the 70s. I don't know, 22, 85, what is that? Yeah. So they probably came out of that generation where their parents still had a lot of bitterness. But let me tell you about kids that were raised in the 80s. So General Wins and his buddy here were already adults. I was a kid in the 80s. You know who raised me? Claire Huxtable. My dad was an alcoholic. My mom was overwhelmed. I watched The Cosby Show at 8 o'clock on Thursday night. I don't know how many years they were on.
You see, I am not serving Dr. Huxtable, okay?
Okay.
That's the kind of thing that goes on in a restaurant.
Now, I'm going to bring him a cup of coffee, just like he brought me a cup of coffee this morning. And that, young man, is what marriage is made of. It is give and take 50-50. And if you don't get it together and drop these macho attitudes, you are never going to have anybody bringing you anything, anywhere, any place, anytime, ever.
And I looked at Claire Huxtable and I was like, it is possible to do that. Now, we all know that it's impossible to achieve. Now, I now know it's impossible to achieve what Claire Huxtable achieved, but she set the bar for everybody. She was like the whole country's mother. Every little girl was like, oh my gosh, you can be a lawyer and a good mother and keep your house clean and look beautiful and stay fit. Okay. So, by the time our generation came along, all of that stuff was forgotten, and for good reason. It needed to be forgotten. It was in the past. And that's what this guy and the people that believe this stuff, they can't wrap their head around, because I will tell you this. Now, most of my life growing up, we lived in a rural area, and there wasn't really a whole lot of like community or anything. And I left home when I was 17. But my mom still lives in a trailer in South Carolina. We actually didn't live in a trailer, but when I left, right after I left, my dad, cause he was at retirement age, they were really old to be my parents. I have 13 brothers and sisters. I'm the 13 of 14. They were old enough to be my grandparents. He bought a new trailer and a little piece of land on this little road in the South. And to make sure that there was a good place that mom would have when he died. And there have been like three meth labs that have gone in on that little country road. There's only like, I don't know, seven trailers, three meth labs. So just to contrast, rednecks and trailer trash people and inner city ghetto people, those two groups are racist. Now, I don't know if this guy was raised in the inner city, but it's a mindset. You don't have to be in the exact geographical area, but there's this mindset. Everybody else knows better. Why? Why do we know better? Because we see the evidence every day.
Thank you very much. Thank you for your service. Obviously, you guys give of yourselves to do what you're doing. The community, I think we recognize that now that the political juice has been sucked out of the mask distraction, that we have to move forward. And one of the things I wanted to thank you for tonight was the resolution, the non-discrimination resolution, the CRT deal, because it's happening. And as a parent, I speak to other parents. There's a few things that we don't want. I'm biracial. I'm bilingual. I'm multicultural. The fact is, in America, in North Carolina, I can do anything I want. And I teach that to my children. And the person who tells my little pecan color kids that they're somehow oppressed based on the color of their skin would be absolutely wrong and absolutely at war with me. And I think that's the same for every parent. What the mask showed us is that the parents, the most powerful group of people in our country, that they're taking back the wheel. Now, obviously, we had to take the wheel back for the mask, but we're taking the wheel back from Washington all the way to Raleigh and into our local school board. Because CRT, all of that, the parents don't want it. It's a big fat lie. There's not one, if you believe in CRT, I want to tell you, you're a liar. Because that means you look at your black neighbor and say that they're oppressed, and you look at your white neighbor and say that they're evil, regardless of the experience that you've had with them. And we're not going to do that. The parents in the United States of America, right here in North Carolina and Cabarrus County, we know that's not true because we believe the lives we live. The fact is, I've been a business owner right here in North Carolina, and I deal with white people, black people, Hispanic people. My children deal with everybody. And the racism is only happening at the government level and on the media. The fact is, you have racists, and there's like, you can't even find them hardly. You just hear the stories about them. But this is what we're dealing with. The parents are taking the wheel. I have an 8-year-old daughter who is absolutely dynamic, who can do anything. Athletically, intellectually, spiritually, and emotionally, she is a dynamo. And I don't want a man swimming against her in the pool. The fact is, I don't want her playing against boys in soccer. I don't even let my sons rough her up. Do you think I'm going to let your son rough her up? This is what we're talking about. Policy going back to the parents. Because if you think people who love America are willing to fight for it, you haven't met parents yet. Because I'm telling you, parents will go further down any street than anyone who loves their country alone.
And I'm gonna, I don't have that quote in front of me, but I'll put it back up on the screen. This is what that guy said, Dave Estes. He said he was replying to someone, it was a black gentleman. I think he was a VMI alumni, but somebody sent me like the whole exchange, and that black guy's like, well, this, there might be a few bad apples in the white community, but this doesn't apply to everybody. And this is what this guy says: I don't buy that bad apple garbage. And let me go get, my son said this in reply, just right out of his mouth. Like when somebody says something right out of their mouth, this is what they believe. And I wrote down what he said. Hold on. My son is very sharp, well beyond his years. He has wisdom. He said, I do, which is a good thing for you. In other words, my son responding to Dave Estes, he believes that there can be just a few bad apples that make an entire race look bad, but it's not applicable to everybody. So here's some concrete information for you, Mr. Estes and General Wins, who I can only, the likelihood that you don't share these ideas is so unlikely that I don't even need to put a number on it. If you take, here's a research project for everybody. Take the number of people, because this is what this guy's still angry about. This is how ignorant his reasoning is. He's looking at, I don't have the, I have to pull up the information so you can see the exact thing. He is looking at all of the black people in America that have been killed by white people way back. And I guess to date, and I don't know what that number is, but if you look at the number of white people that have been killed by black violent crime, the statistics on that are off the charts. I would almost venture to say that everything's even. If you're this asinine that you look at things like that, then look at the whole picture, because black people have been killing white people in violent crime in cities and whatever, a lot, and not 100 years ago. This is like still ongoing. And then look at the number of black people that are killing each other, because that number's probably higher.
I don't care what people don't like. They got mad when I said I don't support Black Lives Matter, because who they matter to? We kill each other all day. We talk about each other all day.
So the stupidity of the entire doctrine and philosophy behind the ignorant, uninformed mindset of this is just off the charts.
So you don't feel like it's like, you know, it's us versus the white man? Or
man,
us versus
we was taught wrong. We was taught wrong. Don't no mother white man depict my mother destiny. I was in my own way. I was self-sabotage. I got to take accountability for me.
And it does not. And here's another thing about percentage. And nobody was willing to say this, because God forbid we be called racist, which already happened. The reason I'm comfortable saying these things is I know what is in my own heart. And he, you know, I went to a church for years in Hampton called Bethel Temple on Todd's Lane. They call it God's Lane, because there's so many churches there. And we were like 50-50 race. It wasn't even, I was holding in the nursery black children, they were holding my children as babies. That is where the rest of us are at in society, General Wins. I don't know what happened to you and your friend in the late 60s and 70s. I'm sure you or your parents saw some crap, but that's not what's going on any longer in this country. This whole BLM thing that's been manufactured, because I'm not going down that road of this video going forever. So the question is racism supposedly that was just accused, an accusation that was determined by General Wins' own words to be unfounded, the accusation of racism towards black people, is the evidence of racism toward white people? And when I say evidence, I don't just mean this meme. If you look at equity policies that they have put in place in the language of the school, it is racist. This is actual racism toward white people. Is there going to be outrage? Are we going to see it hit the news across the state? Are we going to see somebody be fired? I mean, General P had not done any of the things that they accused him of. Here's General Wins. Oh, one last thing. A mom told me, now I have not, I don't have any way to validate this, but a mom told me that General Wins went to some office on post and asked for the names of all of the parents who've been opposing this. But if we're at a place where they're chasing down moms who are simply trying to find out if there's actual racism at the school, all of the documentation at the school says, oh, we don't discriminate. And then look at this. Look at this. I don't know what else to say. Here's some comedians.
It's funny because, like, black people really don't look at white people with, like, you're the oppressor anymore. It's just something we do. It's just like we like not liking white people, and white people like not liking us. It's like, that's just what we do. It's just. Because I'm not going nowhere, and I'll kill a motherfucker you tell me to go, like, back to Africa. But listen, I'm talking to black people. Stop that fucking horseshit, that go back to Africa shit. First of all, Africans don't like black people. That's first thing. They don't like us. And what the fuck am I going to do in Africa besides fight in some war wearing sweatpants and tuxedo shoes with a fucking with a fucking machete in my hand with a pair of fucking tuxedo shoes and a knife and fighting some goofy ass fucking war? Fuck it.